All right, we are live. Welcome to Kai Talks. We have a special guest with us, Gaurav Gurbakhshani, well, better known as Gaurav Guru on social media. Gaurav, thank you for taking the time out.
Awesome, Abu. Excited to be here. Great Kai Talks. So honored to be here on the talk.
Awesome. So for our listeners, Gaurav is the co-founder of onlinebusiness.org and digitalmarket.com. Two super platforms for online. The first part is for online education and of course digital market. I mean, you have to see to believe it. So I'll let our listeners go there directly, but we'll spend some time discussing it in the second half. Our first half, like I mentioned, Gaurav, we'll try and talk about you as an individual, how you got into this business. And also for our listeners, again, I mean, me and Gaurav have been having conversations almost daily for the past, could be 30 years, three decades. And of course, for our Kite Talks members, as you know, onlinebusiness.org is our online education partner. So there's a lot of learning and especially in a time that we're in now, where more or less everything is moving digital. So that's also one of the reasons we said, let's do virtual backgrounds today for the first time. But no, Gaurav, again, one is thanks. And two is let's start with, you can of course tell us stories along the way, but I would love to start with a point where this was not your, I would say, destined path, right? I know you really well, but from you as an entrepreneur, you started off on a different road. Hotel management, and that was, maybe tell us some stories along the way and how it sort of pivoted to where you are at now, or maybe some stories along the way as well.
Awesome. Thanks a lot for the intro. And I don't know whether I was not destined to get into this industry, but I was definitely not destined to do hotel management for sure. So, but you know, there's no such thing as wasted time. Education wise, I did my hotel management, but even prior to hotel management, we've always been talking about business, always had some ideas of let's do something on our own. I would believe it was ever since fifth or sixth grade. So that entrepreneur bug has, always been there.
Yeah.
So I'm really fortunate that I started young. I started doing this stuff, getting out of our comfort zones when we were fairly young, 20, 21 years old. Before that, of course, good Indian kids going to college, getting those non-important degrees. you got to be there and do that. And like I said, everything kind of adds up. But career-wise, I decided to move out of hotel management and focus more on digital marketing. I didn't have clarity like I had back then that, let's do digital marketing for the rest of my life after I began. But I did know I wanted to be associated with the internet. It's always been so passionate. I've always been so curious about, look at right now, and the world is changing, but the internet is making us together, more and more together. So I think that's my core passion on how people can actually be connected on the internet, whether it's a business, whether it's friends, whether it's, whatever you want to do. At the end of the day, if you have the internet, you've got this fantastic equal opportunity, which I'm the most grateful for today.
Yeah. So I know you started off early with Pragmatis Internet Consulting, and that was you and your dad. At that time, sort of building websites and doing SEO, and that's many years ago, more than 10. Maybe just take us through that thought process and then how you saw that evolve as a business, and then sort of really, become larger than what you actually thought.
So it's an interesting story because, of course, you worked at Pragmatis, so behind the scenes of what really went down there. and my dad and me co-founding it. I think that's like a really cool story, because when I called up my dad to tell him that I'm quitting my hotel management job, he told me, don't you dare, because he had just invested like a ton of money in my education. And the next time I called him up and I told him I'm quitting my really cool job in Bombay, which is paying me well and all that stuff, he told me, don't you dare. But what's interesting was that we ended up working together. So it's a cool story. And back then I was like 20, 21 years old. So definitely needed a mentor, definitely needed direction, definitely needed connections and all that good stuff. So really super fortunate to have got started kind of on the right foot and use contacts, learn about how to build websites, how to build, do SEO. And really like a decade or 12, 15 years ago, they were not even buzzwords. You know, today like SEO has become such a common, everyone knows what SEO is. Everyone has got WordPress. Everyone has got templates. And you know, this is like common knowledge now. So, but 15 years ago, imagine a 20-year-old kid trying to convince a 65-year-old CEO that he knows more than you about your business on the internet. So at that point, I decided to become a comedian because people would find me so funny whenever I tell them that, you know, I'm going to help you with your internet business. But I continued that long enough for people to stop laughing and saying that, like, yeah, you actually have been talking about this stuff. Now do it for me or consult with me, and then I laugh and take their money.
Yeah. How did, I know, of course, at that point, the focus was local, right? Focus was very much Pune, because you're based in Pune, and then through the connections that you had, your dad, me, I mean, we were trying to really grow that business. But then how did it suddenly, then you, I think at that time also, because it's the internet, I think obviously you realize that there's the scope is not local. It's very much anywhere in the world. and so then how did you manage to sort of expand that and make it international and really, really fast?
So again, you know, my love-hate relationship with Pune. And, you know, like, because we've had international experience, because I was fortunate enough, even before studying, even before getting my bachelor's degree, I was lucky enough to go abroad, meet people, learn about different cultures. My siblings traveled abroad. So it wasn't that I had a limited mind of like what business is supposed to be. But because I started out in Pune, because I didn't had like absolutely no idea about business, I reached out to any help that I could get. And all that help happened to be in Pune, which was an amazing testing ground. You know, it's like when you're starting out, you got to use all the assets you have, use all the connections that you have. You have to use the network that you've already been given. And it was awesome because we got to learn there. And when you do something well enough, I think today, then the world is going to notice. Then you're going to have way more opportunities. And it doesn't matter, especially on the internet, whether you've helped like a flower store in Pune, or whether you've helped a hotel, or whether you've helped a pharmacy, or man, you name it. You name it on the internet. The industry and the location, according to me, don't matter.
Yeah.
On the internet, it's about traffic and conversions, right? So once we kind of figure that out, I think we got really fortunate enough to jump onto these international marketplaces.
Yeah.
Where all you needed to do is go and list your profile, go and start bidding on some projects. And there was a chance that you'd get international business. So again, we keep saying back in the day, and now I think we are old. We are officially old by saying like, you know, back in the day, like, but back in the day, 10, 15 years ago, it was fairly easy to get international business because it wasn't that competitive. It was fairly easy to succeed doing anything on the internet. because it wasn't that competitive. So we started going on these marketplaces, getting international business. I think that was like a tipping point for our business, because we are a fairly small, we've always been a very small business. We were operating from Pune then, but you know, earning like a couple of crores back then, working with international clients, working with friends, working with family, doing something that you enjoy. So definitely good days.
Nice. And going back to your dad, I know eventually I would say got bought out of the business. So he must have been a happy man, saying, okay, listen, finally I listened to Gaurav and I took the right call.
Yeah, I don't know whether people will ever accept that, but we keep joking about all my mistakes finally coming through and paying back. So it was definitely an awesome moment. And I think business, no matter who you do with, you got to keep paying it forward, and you got to keep learning, and you got to keep doing stuff. So it was an amazing introduction to actually getting started doing business.
So I want to fast forward to now, right? So, I mean, it's been almost a couple of decades that you've been sort of learning about the internet. And I look up to you as somebody who's continuously sort of learning, right? You're continuously reading more. You're continuously, I mean, there's not a time where you're not trying to find something new. And because there's so much of knowledge out there. But I think the other side of it is where at this point now the way we can call it at this point is giving back. Where you're teaching the others to sort of be able to deliver what their full potential on the internet. And so maybe tell us how onlinebusiness.org started, and then we can jump to digital market.
Sure. So onlinebusiness.org, as the name suggests, it's all about online business. And that's something that I've been super passionate about. I've just loved the concept of really being able to potentially make money sitting from home, sitting from wherever you want, one computer. And now you have the potential to earn as much money as you possibly want to, which is, it's still fascinating. It still gives me goosebumps, even though I say something like this every single day. But think about it. We all have this equal opportunity, which we never had before. Like, I kid you not, before the internet, we did not have equal opportunities. If you lived in Pune, you would have a life of Pune expectations. Yeah. You know, if you lived in Bombay, you'd have a life of Bombay expectations, or whichever part of the world you are. And today it's like amazing, where all you need is a cheap internet connection, a computer, and you can compete with anybody in the world. It doesn't matter whether they went to Harvard Business School. It doesn't matter whether they went to some super fancy Ivy League or whatever, because the education, the actual education that we did not have before, today is common knowledge to everybody. Nobody can say that, oh, I don't know. That means you're just being stupid if you don't know. You've got all the tools, all the resources, everything that you possibly can need to right. succeed on the internet. Of course, you need guidance. Of course, you need clarity. Of course, there's trial and error. Of course, there's failures. Of course, there's so many things. But you're still in a way more, you're still way more likely to succeed today if you really wanted to than any time in the history of the universe.
Yeah.
So that's why online business, anybody who wants to get online, who wants to transform their business, even if it's sports, you know, even if it's something like sports, which is so hardcore physical, we are seeing trends evolving to the internet, where you've got extremes of sports, and then you've got other businesses which have found it a lot easier to adapt anyway to the internet. So we teach people, like you said, yeah, every day there's something new. There's a new piece of software. 15 years ago, it would take you 2 months to build a website. Today, it takes you 20 minutes to build a website.
20 minutes, that's crazy, yeah.
And so there's always something new there's always a new software, there's always a new tool. I won't say there's always a new platform, because you have your Google and you have your Facebook and you have your email, but then you also do have a new blog. You also have got a new website, which there's no way you can possibly know, but there's always some business owner, there's always someone who's having like a great idea, who's done something, and it's going to take the whole world time to know about, you know, that platform, whatever you're trying to push out there.
Yeah. Man, and that takes just that much sort of time and research and energy and no, it's and you guys help people get that information, I guess.
Yeah, it's super rewarding, you know, like one of my coolest feelings, and I'm sure like a lot of people will relate to this, is if you are working on the internet and you wake up in the morning and you check your email, and there's like someone sent you money, you've made sales when you sleep, when you're sleeping. In the morning, you check your inbox and being like, Arup sent you 15,000. This one sent you 20,000. This one sent you 2,000. You wake up feeling like, wow, awesome. Like you're just like ready to go every single day. It doesn't get tiring. I promise you that feeling never gets like, oh yeah, wow, I earn extra money. It's always like, wow, I've always earned some money at night, and this can happen throughout the day because the internet doesn't sleep. But I'll tell you another amazing feeling that I get today is when other people email me and tell me like, dude, I made money when I was sleeping. And because I know the feeling, like I know how amazing it is. I know amazing it is. So I'm like, wow, this is equally amazing to know that you too have done it. You transitioned, and it is a mental barrier to a lot of people that it's a legit business. Like, I mean, it totally makes sense to us. Like, what it makes sense. But for a lot of people, it's like, how, what's this technology? Is it safe? You know, will it work? Will I get paid? How will I get paid? Do I trust you? Do you trust me? How do we track? There are like so many questions, which if you don't take that leap of faith, you just will never know.
Yeah. Digitalmarket.com. I mean, that's a, I mean, just that domain itself is a game changer. How did that sort of come about, and what's the goal with that, and what have you guys done so far, and where do you see that headed? I mean, at the end of the day, I know you and I have spoken about it at length, but would love to understand your perspective, and also because I see it as a, I mean, it's related to every single industry. And that's why, I mean, from a sport perspective as well, there are enough of, well, individuals, freelancers and other people who want to, one is learn about the internet. That's one, and learn about how they can better their business. But at the same time also need, people and tools and, ways for them to sort of upgrade what they're doing currently. So yeah, just I'll leave you to sort of jump into it, and then we can get into more detail.
Awesome. So like we here, after a lot of time, have started coming up with these things called frameworks. You know, otherwise every time we did something new, it was new. We would learn something, and then we had to go all across to explain it to ourselves, to explain it to clients. We said, hey, let's come up with a framework. And now it's not that a framework that we like decided to draw in a book and saying that, hey, this is our framework. But based on history, based on how we actually started by doing. You know, we started by doing, which means that my dad would be like, hey, there's this customer. We'd go sit in front of the customer, talk to them. Okay, you need a website? Sure. Go back, learn how to build a website after taking the money. Learn how to build a website. Do the website. And then collect the rest of the money. So it's always kind of started with learn, which has its advantages, but it also has its disadvantages. Like you need to have some kind of background knowledge and stuff like that. So our framework has always been learn, do, teach. So learn how to do it yourself, and then teach someone how to do it. Learn, do, teach, learn, do, teach. So online business is all about learning how to do it, learning how to do it. We are teaching people how to do it, which is good. It's a business, you know, it's a business by itself. today you don't know how to do business online and you join our program and you come for our live classes, XYZ, fast forward sometime later, you'll feel a lot more confident saying that, okay, I at least know how to run an online business. I need to have my blog. I need to have traffic. I need to have all these things. You'll be able to draw a puzzle. You'll be able to draw a plan saying that, yes, this is my business. But the reality of it is now that it is getting more complex. And not everybody is a millennial. I mean, I love these guys who are just like inborn with all these tech skills, and you ask them to do anything and they can do it. They will do it. It's naturally inclined to them for them to be able to build websites, to be able to do video editing, to be able to do all these different things. They can do all these things right now. But the reality is that not too many people actually take action. And you know, if you don't take action, then all the knowledge in the world is absolutely useless.
Yep.
Right. So where do you, that's where the triangle comes in. If you just learn and don't do, it's a failure. If you just do, it's better than just not just learning, but then there's a chance that you're aiming in the wrong direction. You aren't trained, you're figuring stuff out by yourself. Especially if you're a business owner, then you know you don't have the time to experiment. It's not a hobby. It's not fun. It could be fun, but it's not supposed to be fun. You're not supposed to be spending out half your day in learning the software that I spend learning that software. You have to run your sports business. I have to run a digital business, right? So that's where we kind of came up with Digital Market, where it was a missing link, where now we've trained hundreds, if not thousands of people. But these hundreds, if not thousands of people, they don't necessarily want to be full-on business owners. They want to be freelancers. They want to, instead of having a job in a corporate environment, they want to work for themselves.
Yeah.
Which is amazing, right? I wanted to work for myself for the past so many years. So again, if somebody else wants to work for themselves, it's my duty, it's my passion to build them a bridge for them to be able to actually work from home. Mm-hmm. So keeping our experience of working on these international platforms like Upwork and on Fiverr and in digital marketing, you know, fast forward 12, 15 years, we said, you know, hell with it. Why should we work on platforms? Let us become the platform, because we are truly understand. We understand what customers are going through. We understand what freelancers are going through. And we obviously understand business, which is platforms and marketplaces. So let us reinvent ourselves to actually become an agency, you know, a new age agency on the internet where we are enabling buyers and sellers, which I think is a core of the internet.
Nice. And so far you guys have, you know, you have multiple, like you said, hundreds, if not thousands of certified freelancers on the platform. And of course, I've seen it firsthand in terms of the different products and projects and well, in today's terms, gigs available out there for people. And it's the way I look at it, it's for individuals, businesses, existing, running, brick and mortar. At the end of the day, like you said, if you're not online, especially in this particular time, you're definitely doing something wrong. So I think you guys are totally, hitting the nail on its head, for lack of a better saying.
Awesome. Yeah, really happy to be here. And I think it's all about starting young. You know, you can't turn back time, but you're always young enough to start. You're always young enough to sing that this is the time. This is a sweet time in history to be like nature. Nature is forcing you to get onto the internet, if you think about it. Like saying that, don't come out, don't step out, we don't want you out. Sit in your house, connect to the internet, and now figure it out.
Yeah. You got to pay your bills, figure it out. Burn money online and pay them online. Absolutely. No need to sort of step out of your house. But tell me something. So where do you see this headed? Where is it all going? What's the sort of ideal scenario like? I mean, for you guys, or is it number of sort of people on the platform? Is it the number of countries that y'all are going to be functioning in? Or what's the I know there's no crystal ball, but obviously there's some. I mean, you at some stage you'd be like, oh wow, okay, this is we've got there, or this is halfway there.
Man, you know, like to an extent, I feel like we're already there, in the sense that this has always been the day that I've been wishing for, where we can help people across the world connect with each other. And number is a score, right? So number is a score, whether you have 100 or whether you have 1,000 or whether you have 10,000 or whether you have 1,000,000 or you have 10 million, 100 million or 1,000,000,000, they are all numbers at the end. If I was to pull out a number, I think like 1,000,000,000 sounds cool, 1,000,000,000 of anything kind of sounds cool. So where I think this is headed is it's a future of work. It's a future of work. I think it is something that's going to help in things that I feel pretty strong against, like racism. And, you know, I think that's going to change, because now you can be a nameless, faceless soul. You can be someone who's black. You can be someone who's brown. You can be a Muslim. You can be a Christian. You can be whoever the hell you want, working in any part of the world that you want. But I'm not going to judge you based on any of these stupid factors about your color and your religion. I'm going to judge you based on how well you can do your job. And is that job going to make me money?
Correct.
That's it. That's the bottom line. There's nothing else. I don't care about anything else about you. There's no guy. There's no girl. There's no anything else. You know, if for whatever reason at least on my marketplace, if you don't like me or if I don't like you, move on. You know, move on. I'm not committed to you. You're not committed to me. You don't owe me. I don't owe you. I'm not going to come and ask you for a salary every single month. You know, it's all good. It's completely performance-based.
Yeah.
It's completely performance-based. And it's about short-term gigs. You know, I think that's something that people need to adapt to, depending on, you know, which country you are in. You know, we've seen how other employees are treated in other businesses, right? Where you're suddenly like a slave, or you're suddenly like you're owned by a bad boss. And not even the bad boss is the owner of the company. It's a bad boss acting for a bad boss who's acting for a bad boss who's acting for some guy who doesn't even know that all these people are acting bad because of him.
Correct. Right?
And I don't want that to happen to men. I don't want that to happen to family men with kids, where, you know, you put on a brave face, you go to work, you do what you hate just to provide for your family, because providing for your family is the ultimate thing. But why should you have to go through this? You know, is this what 1/3 of your life is dedicated towards? Working for somebody who doesn't like you, who does, you get the drift, right? So I think like each person who we're able to make a difference to, it's great. As an entrepreneur, being ambitious in wanting to more people to experience this work from home, wanting people to experience all this, like the more the merrier for me. You know, more the merrier. It'll definitely help us earn more money if we get more people, but that's kind of never been the underlying essence. It's like, let's do something awesome. Let's add value to this world. And then the profits and the money is going to follow.
Yeah, let's add value. I think that's a key, man. At the end of the day, that's like, I think, and also you've always sort of stuck by that. Listen, deliver value and everything else will follow, right?
Absolutely. 100%.
There's no point focusing on, oh, let me think of the numbers, let me think of the money, let me think of the profits. No, just give value and everything else will come.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
No, yeah, no, that's awesome. But a couple of, I mean, just from closing, I know we have a few minutes left, but just maybe some closing thoughts in terms of, well, not focused at the millennials, but focused at more our sort of generation where I mean, what should people sort of be doing in this digital world now? And again, we are doing a sort of online conference where I'd rather be sitting with you and having a cup of coffee. But again, what should businesses, individuals be doing? Again, just maybe a little bit of advice or anything that you have to say.
So are we millennials or are we?
No, we're not. We're borderline, but we're not.
So I'm going to consider myself as one.
You go for it. Go for it.
Yeah, so I think what should people be doing? It's really simple, man. Age is no bar. It doesn't matter if you are young, good for you, awesome. You know, you've got a longer time to live, I guess. But for whoever is out there, no matter what age you are, it's just a question of being able to adapt. And humans are born to adapt. Humans are very capable of adapting. I know that for a fact, because just a couple of minutes ago, I received a message from my grandmom, who's 80, 88, 89 years old. And she is my number one fan on Instagram, because nice. She's following me on Instagram. She's following me on Facebook. And now when I do go and meet her, she'd ask me about, so how was your conference? Oh, I know you did a webinar. Okay, Arup, I saw you guys were talking together. She's definitely going to be checking this out as well.
For sure, I know. She likes a bunch of my posts, I know.
So isn't that awesome? So
Yeah.
My kid, Ray, who's like 18 months, he can switch on like the iPad and he knows YouTube. And between him and his sister, they figured it out. So if an 18-month-year-old and an 88-year-old person can figure this out, there's no excuse. There's just absolutely no excuse. And it's the best time, like I feel, not just from a business standpoint. It's about connection. So if you are lonely, you know, loneliness is such a huge problem in this world, right? It's such a huge problem. If you're able to use technology, not to replace that problem, but at least to connect you to more like-minded people, it's lovely, that, right? You can change your entire life. Like, I know my life has changed right from the people who I met, people who I meet, to the people who I marry, to the people who I'm friends with, to people who I do business with. You know, people who I marry, hopefully just one, but the other, like making friends and building businesses and doing all these things, it's starting on the internet. It's starting on the internet. It's continuing on the internet. It's finishing on the internet. So just embrace it. You know, embrace it. And I think the world is kind. I think the world is kind, which means that if you want to put yourself out there, if you want to get discovered, there's a good chance somebody's going to be able to help you. Maybe not your kid. You know, unfortunately, it's this thing that children are not going ahead and helping their parents, saying that, hey, sit down, I am going to show you this. I am going to show you Facebook. I am going to show you LinkedIn, because I think it's our duty. You know, I think it's our duty to teach the generation who's taught us, right? And hopefully the generation who we've taught teaches us, and it moves on that way. But many times I've heard from people saying that, oh, I know it's there, but you know, my kids, they just never show me. So I'm like, let's not talk any further. Let me show you. Let me show you something. Let me show you that one thing, whether it's an Amazon or whether it's a Big Basket or whether it's a Dunzo, whether it's a matchmaking website, whether it's something, because there's so many opportunities, and that one thing and that one relationship can change your entire life.
Yeah. No, that's awesome. Thanks, man. That's, I think there's a lot of takeaways, and I know we can continue the conversation always and talk about the world of online, world of digital is just, it's unending. But yeah, for our listeners, Gaurav Guru, follow him on Instagram. He has a lot of goodies and things, but and of course digitalmarket.com is there for the taking. Feel free to jump on there and use the platform. But again, thanks for the time, and we'll I know this is not going to be the last conversation, so I'll talk soon.
Yeah, hopefully not. And thank you for doing what you are doing, and looking forward to watching this 10 years, 15 years from now and reminiscing on whether this was a good idea or not.
I like that. Cheers, buddy.
Cheers. Thank you.